Legal Aspects of Banking, Paper 3 for JAIIB, File Number 2. Unit 13, Various Type of Securities, Land or Real Estate, Stocks and Shares, Debentures, Clause 212. A document issued by the company acknowledging its indebtedness to the bearer or registered holder. A fixed rate of interest is payable at stated periods on such debentures. A table has given of for advantages and disadvantages of this. Advantages. Point 1. Ease to sell. Point 2. Not subject to violent price fluctuations. Point 3. They can be transferred at minimum cost. Point 4. Bearer debentures are fully negotiable. Point 5. They ranked in priority to shares and mostly secured by a charge on the company's property. Disadvantages. Point 1. If interest is not paid, it would affect its price and marketability. Point 2. If a charge on property of company is not registered, the subsequent charges will get priority. Point 3. Debentures may be issued by the company having no power to borrow money. Goods. Life policies. Book debts. Clause 218. Borrowers can take advances by assigning book debts in favor of the bank. Fixed deposit. Supply bills. Supply bills arise in relation to transactions with the government and public sector undertakings. A party might have taken a contract for execution and he is entitled to progress payments on the basis of work done, for which he has to submit bills in accordance with the terms and conditions of the contract. Unit 14, Law relating to securities and modes of charging, Part 1. Mortgage, Clause 226. Section 58 of the Transfer of Property Act, 1882, defines a mortgage is the transfer of interest in specific immovable property for the purpose of securing the payment of money advanced or to be advanced by way of loan on existing or future debt or the performance of an engagement which may give rise to a pecuniary liability. 1. Point 1. Simple mortgage. Section 58, Clause B. The mortgagee has no power to sell without intervention. No right to get any payments out of the rents. Not in possession of the property. Registration is mandatory. Point 2. Mortgage by conditional sale. 58, Clause C. The sale is ostensible and not real. If the money is not paid on the agreed rate, the ostensible sale will become absolute upon the mortgager applying to the court and getting a decree in his favor. The mortgagee can sue for foreclosure but not for sale of the property. There is no personal covenant for repayment of the debt and therefore bankers do not prefer this type of mortgage. Point 3. Number 3. Usufructuary mortgage. 58, Clause D. The mortgagee is put in possession of the mortgaged property. Here by possession means legal possession, not a physical possession. The mortgagee has the right to receive rents and profits accruing from the property. Mortgagee cannot sue the mortgager for repayment of the debt, sale or foreclosure of the mortgaged property. If the mortgager fails to bring a suit for redemption within 30 years, the mortgagee becomes absolute owner of the property. Bankers do not prefer this form of mortgage for the following reasons. There is no personal covenant to repay the debt. It will take very long time to recover money through this process. Point 4. English mortgage. 58, Clause E. It provides for personal covenant. There is an absolute transfer of the property in favor of the mortgagee. Property shall be reconveyed to the mortgager in the event of repayment of mortgage money. The mortgagee can sue the mortgager for the recovery of the money. Point 5. Mortgage by deposit of title deeds or equitable mortgage. 58, Clause F. Where a person in any of the towns notified by the government concerned may, delivers to a creditor or his agent documents of title to immovable property with intent to create a security thereon. The transaction is called a mortgage by deposit of title deeds. Number 6. Amalgamous mortgage. 58 plus G. It is combination of two mortgages. A. Simple and usufructuary mortgage by B. Usufructuary mortgage accompanied by conditional sale. Unit 15. Law relating to securities and modes of charging, Part 2. Pledge and mortgage. The comparison of pledge and mortgage has given here. Pledge. Pledge required only a limited interest in the property and ownership remains with the right of pledger. In mortgage, here the legal ownership passes to mortgagee, of course subject to the mortgager to redeem the property. In pledge, the pawnee has special property in the goods degree of pledged. In mortgage, the mortgage as a takes to. In pledge, pawnee has no right to foreclosure. Pawner, P-A-W-N-O-R, the person whose goods are bailed. Pawnee, P-A-W-N-E, the person who takes the goods for security. Pledge means bailment of goods for the purpose of securing a payment of debt or an obligation. A valid pledge can be created by owner of goods or a mercantile agent. A constructive pledge involves only delivery of keys of the warehouse. Under the contract of pledge, the pawnee can sell the goods pledged after notice or retain the goods and file a suit for recovery of debt. Here a table has given for hypothecation and mortgage. Hypothecation. Point 1. The mortgage of movable property is called hypothecation. Number 2. There is only obligation to repay the money and no transfer of interest. In mortgage, point 1. Mortgage relates to immovable property. Point 2. There is transfer of interest to the creditor. Unit 16. Different types of borrowers. Minor. A person who has not attained the age of 18 years under Indian Majority Act and 21 years if he is ward under Guardians and Wards Act. Types of borrowers. In 1. Individual. 2. Partnership firm. 3. Hindu undivided family and Mitakshara schools. Joint Hindu family is governed basically by two schools of thought. They are Dayabhag. 4. Companies. 5. Statutory corporations. 6. Trust and cooperative societies. Unit 17. Types of credit facilities. Types of credit facilities. 1. Fund-based credit facilities. 1. Cash credits or overdrafts. Cash credit or overdraft is an arrangement by which a banker allows his customer to borrow money up to a certain limit. 2. Term loans. 3. Bill finance. Non-fund based credit facilities. 1. Bank guarantee. 2. Letter of credit facility. Rule in Clayton's case. Discharge of debt items by subsequent credits was enunciated in a case called Clayton's case. Unit 18. Secured and unsecured loans. Registration of firms. Incorporation of companies. Types of securities. Pledge. Section 172 to 176 Indian Contract Act. For constituting valid pledge, there must be delivery of goods to pawnee. Delivery of possession can be actual or constructive. 2. Hypothecation. As a charge against property of the borrower for an amount of debt where neither ownership nor possession is passed to creditor. 3. Mortgage is defined as the transfer of an interest in specific immovable property for the purpose of securing the payment of money advanced or to be advanced by way of loan and existing future debt or the performance of an engagement which may give rise to pecuniary liability. 4. Assignment of debts. Consequences of non-registration of firm. 1. Suits by partners inter se. 2. Suits by a firm against third parties. 3. Exceptions. 4. Non-application of Section 69. Certain suits. Incorporation of a company. A. Type of company. B. Name of company. C. Memorandum of association. Is the constitution of a company and, amongst other things, defines the area within which the company can act. D. Articles of association. Contains the rules and regulations relating as to the internal management of a company. E. Preparation of the other documents. F. Payment of registration fees. G. Certificate of incorporation is the conclusive evidence of coming into existence of the company. H. Certificate of commencement of business is required for a public company to start business. Unit 19. Registration and satisfaction of charges. Charge is used to mean any form of security for debt. Types of charges. 1. Fixed charge is also called specific charge. It extends over a specific property. 2. Floating charge means a charge A. that floats over the present and future property of the company. B. that does not restrict the company from assigning the property subject to third persons, whether by way of sale or security. C. that on happening of an event or contingency crystallizes as a fixed charge. Procedure for registration of charge. Effect of non-registration of charges. Section 125 of the Companies Act provides that the charge created by the company over the properties, if not registered, would not be valid against the liquidator and any creditor of the company. Provisions of law relating to registration of charges, Clause 289. Section and description. Section 124. Description. Charge meaning. Section 125. Description. Registration of charge. Section 126. Description. After registration. Section 127, 128, 129. There is nothing. No description. For Section 130. Description. Register of companies shall keep register of charges. Section 131. In description. Index of register of charges. Section 132, description, certificate of the charge has been created. Section 133, 134, 135, 136, no description. 137, description, appointed receiver or manager shall give notice to register of companies. Section 138, description, satisfaction of charge. Section 139, no description. Section 140, description, memorandum of satisfaction. Section 141, description, company law board can order creation or modification or satisfaction of charge. Section 142, description, impose penalty on the company. Section 143, company keeps a register of charges. Section 144, description, any member of company can inspect the books relating to charges creating by the company. Unit 20, Introduction to Surface Act 2002, Clause 295. 1.1. Banks obtain security while lending so that in case needs the money can be realized by sale of securities. 2. The Surface Act is applicable to the housing finance companies whose names are notified by the central government. 3. Movable securities in possession of the bank can be sold by the bank without intervention of the court. Yes, bank can sell as provided in the Contract Act 1872. 4. As per the laws existing today, the mortgage security cannot be sold without court intervention. No, Surface Act 2002 has now made enabling provisions. 5. Provisions of Surface Act 2002 apply to which securities? Where security interests are created for repayment of financial assistance given by bank or financial institution. 6. In Mardia case, what the Supreme Court declared as invalid? condition to pay 75% of the amount as precondition while preferring appeal to the DRT. Unit 21. Definitions at SARFAESI Act 2002. Point 1. Preamble, an act to regulate securitization and reconstruction of financial assets and enforcement of security interest and for matters connected therewith or incidental thereto. 2.2. Appellate tribunal. Any person aggrieved by the order passed by DRT can file an appeal to the authority called as appellate tribunal. 3. Asset reconstruction. 4. Bank. All the banking companies, nationalized banks, cooperative banks, SARFAESI Act is not applicable to RRBs. 5. Board. SEBI under SEBI Act 1992. 6. Borrower. Granted financial assistance given guarantee has. 7. Central registry. All the transactions of asset securitization, reconstruction as well as transactions of creating security interest will have to be registered with this authority. 8. Debt recovery tribunal. These tribunals deals with the cases of recovery of debts above rupees 10 lakh due to banks and financial institutions. Point number 9. Default. 10. Financial assistance. 11. Financial asset clause 302. A claim to any debt or receivables and includes claim to any debt or receivables or part thereof, whether secured or unsecured, or any debt or receivable secured by mortgage of or charge on immovable property, or a mortgage charge, hypothecation or pledge of movable property, or any right of interest in the security, whether full of part, securing debt, or 12. Financial institution. 13. Hypothecation. 14. Non-performing asset. 15. Originator. 16. Obligor. Borrower or any other person liable to pay the bank. 17. Property. 18. Qualified institutional buyer. 19. Reconstruction company. 20. Scheme. 21. Securitization. 22. Securitization company. The minimum capital requirement is rupees 200 crore at the time of registration, and these companies are required to maintain minimum capital adequacy ratio of 15% of total asset acquired or rupees 100 crore, whichever is less. It is company registered under Companies Act 1956 for the purpose of securitization. The company also needs registration with RBI. Point number 23. Security agreement means an agreement, instrument or any other document under which security interest is created. Point 24. Secured asset means property on which security interest is created. The powers given by SARFAESI Act for enforcement of securities are against secured assets only. Point 25. Secured creditor. Point 26. Secured debt means a debt which is secured by any security interest. Point 27. Secured interest. Any right, title and interest of any kind who whatsoever upon the property created in favor of any secured creditor is called as secured interest. 28. Secured receipt. 29. Sponsor is a person holding not less than 10% of the paid up equity capital of securitization company. 1. When any bank or financial institutions creates a charge against property, with which authority the transaction will have to be registered under the SARFAESI Act 2002 with the Central Registry. 2. When the provisions of SARFAESI Act 2002 can be invoked for proceeding against the charged property, when there is default in repayment and the bank declares the account as NPA. 3. Acquisition of financial asset from the originator is the main function of securitization company. Point 4. If the borrower does not pay within 60 days after notice by the secured creditor, the creditor can take possession of the security. Point 5. Enforcement of Safraisi Act only if security is not in possession of the bank and financial institution. Unit 22, Regulation of Securitization and Reconstruction of Financial Assets of Banks and Financial Institutions. Registration of Securitization Company or Reconstruction Company can commence or carry business if 1. Obtain certification of registration from RBI. Point 2. It has own funds not less than 2 crores. Cancellation of certificate of incorporation. Point 1. The company ceases to carry on the business. Point 2. The company ceases to receive or hold any investment from a qualified institutional buyer. Point 3. The company fails to comply with any of the conditions subject to which the certificate of registration was granted. Point 4. Fails to comply with RBI directions. Point 5. Fails to maintain accounts in accordance with directions issued by RBI. Point 6. Fails to give accounts and documents to RBI for inspection. Asset reconstruction means acquisition of any right or interest of any bank or of financial institution in any financial asset for the purpose of realization. Securitization company needs registration from RBI for commencement of business. Right of acquisition of financial asset by securitization company or RC is subject to the prior agreements or contracts about the asset. False. Acquisition of financial asset by securitization company or RC is with the liability also over such asset. False. The four documents involved in the securitization transaction. Clause 314. Offer document. Full details of financial asset, loan details of bank, etc. Debenture. A debenture for payment of consideration to be paid to the bank or financial institution for acquisition asset from it. Agreement. It is with originator to continue to service the assets. Security receipt. It is in favor of investors. Any direction issued by the RBI under Safraisi Act has statutory effect and is binding on the parties concerned. After application of Safraisi Act, existing companies have to get registered within 6 months from commencement of the Act. Unit 23. Enforcement of security interest, Clause 325. When immovable property is obtained as security by way of mortgage for its sale and realization of money, court intervention is required. Similarly, in case of movable property, except the pledged security, court intervention is required. The Safraisi Act empowers bank and financial institutions to enforce securities in the event of default of borrower without intervention of either civil court or the DRT. Manner and effect of takeover of management. No compensation to the directors for loss of office. Right to prefer application to DRT. Any person including borrower aggrieved by any of the measures taken by the SC or his authorized officer for taking possession of the security may apply to the DRT. 1. With the prescribed fees within 45 days. 2. If application by borrower, he has deposited 50% of the amount claimed in the notice under Section 13, Clause 2 of the Safraisi Act. Number 3. The DRT has to dispose of the application within 60 days. If not possible, then DRT has to record reasons for delay, but such delay should not be beyond 4 months. If any such application is not disposed within 4 months, the aggrieved party can prefer an application to the appellate tribunal for seeking early disposal of the application. Appeal to the appellate authority. Any person aggrieved by any order by the DRT under can prefer appeal along with the prescribed fees to the appellate tribunal within 30 days from the date of the receipt of the order of the DRT. Different fees for borrower's appeal and appeal by any other than borrower. The borrower has to deposit 50% of the debt claimed by the SC. The tribunal has power to reduce this amount up to 25%. Right of borrower for compensation and costs. Point 1. If the DRT or AT, as the case may be, on the appeal holds that 1. The possession of secured asset by the SC is not in accordance with the provisions of the acts or rules. 2. The SC should return such secured asset to the concerned borrower with compensation and cost as may be determined by the DRT or AT. Point 2. No pecuniary limit is fixed by the Act for the appellate jurisdiction. If any person contravenes or attempts to contravene provisions of the Surfacey Act or rules thereunder, he shall be punishable with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year or with fine or with both. Section 12. RBI is statutorily empowered to issue directions to the SC or RC. If any such company fails to comply with any of the directions issued by the RBI, then such company is punishable with fine not exceeding 5 lakh rupees for the default. In case of further continuation of the offence, additional fine is up to rupees 10,000 per day of default can be imposed. Section 31. Exclusions of the possessory securities to which Act is not applicable. 1.1. A lien on any goods, money or security given by or under the Indian Contract Act 1872. 2. A pledge of movable within meaning of Section 172 of the Indian Contract Act 1872. 3. Any conditional sale, hire purchase or lease or any other contract in which security interest has been created. 4. Any rights of unpaid seller. 5. Any security interest for securing repayment of any financial asset not exceeding rupees 1 lakh rupees. 6. Any security interest created on agricultural land. Section 20, 21 to 27 that provide for registration of security interest created, satisfaction of charge created. Unit 24, Central Registry, Clause 338. Besides the Surfacey Act, following other laws require registration of charge created in the property. 1. Registration Act 1908. 2. Companies Act 1956. 3. Merchant Shipping Act 1958. 4. Patents Act 1970. 5. Designs Act 2000. A record shall be maintained at the Central Register at the head office of the Central Register in which transactions relating to 1. Securitization of financial assets. 2. Reconstruction of financial assets. 3. Creation of security interest shall be maintained. Under the Surfacey Act, filling of details transactions of securitization, reconstruction and creation of security interest is required to be filed with the Central Register is 30 days after the date of transaction or creation of security. Modification also have to be filled within 30 days. Satisfaction of charge 30 days. Unit 25, Offences and Penalties. Section 12. Section 12 of the Surfacey Act, the RBI is statutory empowered to issue directions to SC or RC. If any such company fails to comply with any of the directions issued by the RBI, then such company is punishable with fine not exceeding rupees 5 lakhs. If any person attempts to contravene, abates the contravention of the provision of the Surfacey Act or rules made there under, he shall be punishable with imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year or with fine or both. Unit 26, Miscellaneous Provisions. Securities not in possession of the bank or financial institutions are only covered by this Act. civil courts not to have jurisdiction. Jurisdiction has conferred to DRT and AT. Section 36 Surfacey Act. The action has to be taken within 3 years from date on which a cause of action arose. Non-applicability of Surfacey Act, Clause 348. File 2 completed.